However, I did notice that around the mansion there seems to be a makeshift minefield. I do believe I have something about that. Give me just a moment. She reaches into thin air and you see her hand disappear, almost like it teleports halfway somewhere. It's some kind of special space that's designed for holding items as far as
some It's an item box.
She sees. She keeps going through it. Let's see. No, not that. No, that's very dangerous poison that you should never touch.
Alyssia perks up at the mention of dangerous poison.
Nope, that's Alicia's conscience and her empathy towards people.
Maybe you should give that back if you're not joking. It might help.
I like you, dear. You're sweet.
And a bit naive.
Let's see. Oh, there we go. She pulls out some kind of small hammer-shaped wooden toy, and she tosses it over to Iris.
Oh, I grab out the air then. So I'm looking at it, like, what the hell?
Right, so, when you reach the minefield, just chuck that thing at it. It will work itself out, don't worry about it.
Okay, just chuck the hammer at the minefield.
Let me guess, the hammer will fly around and smack the mines.
Wow, Alyssia, you lack creativity, don't you? To be fair, though, you are right.
That's...
You lack creativity, but you are right, what?
That's good, because this was my plan, guys.
Alyssia says, well, that is a logical answer.
Anyway, what would you wish to talk with her in private, Lucretia?
I guess we'll start with the serious one first. Well, something's become apparent to me of lately. There's something changing inside of me.
What do you mean? Can you be more specific?
Well, and I'll just basically go over the details of when I use healing magic. It doesn't feel like healing. Well, it heals me, but it doesn't feel right.
I'm so glad you remember about her flowers, Venrik. Anyway, to answer your question, Lucretia, she takes a long, hard look at you. You notice that her eyes are glowing. She's probably using some kind of magic. After a while, she closes them, and when she opens them back, they're back to normal and says, "This is not something I can help you with. It's not my specialty. Gordon will probably be able to help you, though."
Oh, well... Just knowing a little bit more about what's going on is fine for now, I suppose.
Don't worry. You'll have your opportunity to speak with him shortly.
But do you know anything?
Sadly, like I said, no. It's not magic related, whatever your issue is, so I know nothing of it.
Alright, I'll try and speak to Gordon at my earliest convenience.
If you want... I can cast the magic to confuse your brain and make you feel great when you're being healed, or even feel an orgasm, depending on what you want.
No, thank you. I Bucking feel like slaneshi. That would be a hindrance if I'm in the middle of battle and then that happens. But, on to the next thing. When we were doing combat training before, I wasn't able to use one of my many few offensive miracles. Simply because they were fire and we were indoors. I was wondering if there was any way to, enhance my shield so I could, change the aspect of what it does, change parts of it, like maybe instead of a ball of fire, it's a ball of something else.
Anri does to your request is she leans back in a very dramatic manner and gasps loudly. Everybody is super shocked because they have no idea what she is doing and why. And then you hear it in your mind, you're the only one that hears her words. Why, Lucretia, are you asking to be able to cast magic? Isn't that heresy?
No, I'm not asking to be able to cast magic, it's just enhanced miracles. At this point, everyone can see my face has gone completely red.
By the way, I love that. Good
Alicia
terminology.
Puts two and two together, these guys have something going on.
It's not magic, it's enhanced miracles.
Yeah, it's not like interrogation. That wasn't techniques. Obvious.
Enhanced interrogation, get the water out.
Yeah, it's not magic, it's enhanced miracles.
Now where's my dildo?
I'm just enhancing the holy symbol that I use to cast my miracles to make my miracles more versatile. It's still miracles, it's not magic.
Tell you what, Lucretia, when you have some downtime, I'll take that shield off your hands and see if there's something I can do with my specific talents. Hopefully sometime before, well, she looks out the window and towards the ship. Before you have to deal with that. But for now, something tells me you're going to be needing your shield, so let's leave it at that.
She just kind of nods. Alright, so now, both on the to-do list, I gotta give my shield to that guy to enhance it, and I gotta give it to Henri to also enhance it.
You should probably at some point drop by and drop off all the weapons you wanna upgrade.
Yeah, that I was about to go to that, and now I'm gonna speak aloud and say, now, speaking of which, well, actually, I suppose you don't know what I... Never mind, so... I'm gonna tell them the situation with Bush. Butch.
With Bush.
Not about the Bush.
Wait, who the fuck is Butch?
Butch is the engineer. Basically, if you want any of your stuff enhanced, give it to me and I'll drop it off.
Eos looks a bit upset. She's like looking down at her fists.
Speaking of which, if you do manage to do that, Albert has been getting a little restless lately. He's been sleeping less and less, saying, yammering about how he wants to get in touch with you guys since it's been a while. So, I guess you could look forward to that if you set up the teleporter.
That doesn't sound like him. Did someone forget his favorite pillow?
Yeah, I was pretty shocked myself.
Quite so suddenly sitting up with genuine concern for Albert.
I imagine the current owner of that mansion would not take kindly to us attempting to set up a portal there.
Well, considering you tried to kill him and wounded him, he probably wouldn't be up for anything right now, so... But, you know, I'm just saying. Maybe I'm wrong, who knows?
That being said...
Can I roll medicine to see if I could heal his condition using my,
You'd know that you would only be able to temporarily remove his condition, but not cure it. As for why, you remember what Andre said about this becoming a thing after he bonded with a demon. So basically that's a side effect of his bonding. If you want to cure him permanently, you're going to have to remove the demon from him.
In that case, he's most likely someone who supplied something of interest to the owner of the mansion. Who is most likely the vice president of the steel mill?
That would make sense, or alternatively, she casts another spell and you get another vision of the mansion from a bird's eye view, but this time it's a little further away. You start noticing some unusual things from up below, and Andre mentions it. What if he set up that fortress to guard something?
Guard something? What would he need to guard if he only just got there?
I mean, we don't know when he settled in. If you look up the area around the mansion, he must have painstakingly worked at least for months to set everything up.
What was it like inside, Alyssia? You skipped some details.
Alyssia goes over the interior of the mansion from what she saw.
Wait.
So what you're saying is that not only does he keep up a minefield active, also, there is some kind of search spell involved, and on the inside, he constantly has magic working to confuse people that end up inside.
Wait, why would he bother doing that on the lower levels?
Not only does he have magic inside confusing anyone who enters the mansion, by the way, it doesn't work if you're more than one person, apparently. But secondly, he also has traps. Numerous traps.
What if it's to keep something in?
Now, there's an interesting point you're raising, Kiris. I do believe that that would make sense. Why would you confuse only one person? Sure, to confuse multiple people would be a lot more straining, but he's probably not starving for power. If he set it up for one individual in specific, then maybe he's trying to keep something inside. Curious.
It's highly unlikely.
Looks like the puzzle is starting to come together.
In that case, it's highly unlikely the person you left with has anything to do with it. If he's like you, he may have been hired to find out what's there.
By the way, nothing to do with it.
If you remember, when you went to check on the president of the steel mill and what happened to him, he had a symbol carved on his forehead. The symbol was pretty plain, but you do not recognize it. Do you want to share that with the party?
Actually, she does. She actually just... can I draw on a piece of paper or something I have? A spoon, yep. Talisman, since I have a good one.
You can pretty much vaguely describe it, and both Lucretia and Horatius will instantly recognize it without even having to roll. Alyssia, through association and people she knows, would definitely know the symbol as well. The symbol that Logan carved into the president of the steel mill's head is the one that you give to the absolute scum of the earth. It's basically a branding. Like, for instance, in our world, if you go to prisons, you know that the most hated people are people that put their hands on children, right? Even the other prisoners are like, no, you guys are scum, and fuck them up, right?
Yep.
That's why Exposure stays out of prisons.
Now, so basically the kind of carving that Logan carved on that guy's head is that, but that doesn't mean he's a child molester, it just means that he is an absolute scum and doesn't deserve to live. He's the worst type of person ever. So, good luck with that. And she very theatrically claps her hands together like a belly dancer that's just making a pose. And boom! She disappears in a puff of smoke. The entire tavern is rocked again and everybody is cursing and super mad again.
Right then. So I suppose off we go.
Okay, let's prepare. Where did City go? No! Where's our ship posting?
It's all gone, I'm sorry.
We are the ship posting. You heard him, guys. Ship posting's gone. Time for Vendrick posting.
Okay, fine. Iris will make the approach.
I'm just letting it know, and I'm bringing a longbow with me. By the way, guys.
Iris, you need to make the approach, because you're not Ulvaean and you didn't shoot him with an arrow.
I do not have a good picture for this situation, so just ignore the background. You can just keep looking at the beautiful city, it's fine. You guys are on the road. It takes you a couple of hours, but thanks to Alyssia knowing the way, and you guys having, well, some of you having special horses, the other ones are surprised. Yeah, you guys, the Ovens don't know about the demon horses, but you actually have the spare whistle, so you can actually give it to them.
Pretty sure I know about the demon horse, right?
Do you?
Yeah,
he would.
Given one.
In that case, Lucretia doesn't know about it.
Sibby knows the way.
Should we disobey?
So, Lucretia, you are given a whistle, and when you whistle, you see a magnificent steed. That's fucking heresy. It's made of 100% heresy.
I'm just gonna kind of look at it. I'm gonna narrow my eyes, and then I just slowly move my eyes to look at Iris.
By the way, as you're doing that, the horse is completely mimicking you and narrows his eyes towards you, then slowly moves over to Iris. On his expression, you can read, Iris, what the fuck? She thinks she killed demons. What the fuck? Why are you making me work with her?
It's okay.
Mine is
horse.
Like, what the fuck? This is a demon. They kill my friends. What the hell?
It's like I'm petting the demon horse. Like, it's okay. It's okay. Don't worry. She's a nice lady.
Now do the same to Lucretia. Otherwise, no fair.
Yeah. It's like, Lucretia, calm down. It's a nice horse.
No, you have to give me head pats.
Okay, wait.
She also pats your head.
Oh, the horse is actually sentient.
No, they're not. I was just being.
Nah, they're just they're more automatons than anything.
They have character, but they're not sentient.
So they're essentially constructs, like Hagrid.
Sort of.
But yeah.
And he's already sitting on top of hers, and she's like. You can probably tell, like, anyone who can actually ride a horse can probably tell that Alyssia cannot ride a horse, actually.
Iris is like, don't worry, the horse is perfectly safe. It's not going to do anything.
That surprises me.
What do you mean?
It never occurred to me she wouldn't be able to ride.
Oh, right, yeah.
Yeah, that is surprising, isn't it?
I mean, she mostly works in cities, why would she be able to ride?
I don't know, it just seems like a skill you'd have, especially given your career.
Yep.
Nope.
But yes, Lucretia, I'm
infected
with your new glorious heresy's teeth.
I'm only getting on it if Horatius is.
I'm already saddling mine and getting on.
Good demon horse.
Is there enough horses for everybody?
Yes.
Damn it. Okay, I'll get on mine.
It's like, you need
by
help?
The way, as you're getting on your horse,
I know how to ride a horse.
Suddenly you feel all eyes are on you. You feel absolute shame. It's almost like you wanted to become the head priestess, but you became the demon lord instead.
As soon as I froze a heresy, now I'm sitting on a demon horse.
By the way, you guys are laughing, but that's actually a reference because I showed her an anime where the guy is super good and wants to become literally the Pope, but he instead becomes the demon lord, and it's like, not like this, what?
I'm sulking. I'm just like sitting there scowling.
So did the guy then wear mirror shades and say, I never asked for this?
Yeah, pretty much.
Well, he tried to do a bunch of good shit and it was always interpreted as being evil.
Could be worse. You could be Lolly Hitler.
He's basically Lolly. The good guy that always does good things, but everybody thinks he's evil. He's basically a reverse Felazar.
Well, at least I'm not Lolly Hitler.
Yeah.
I mean, they just started their career as a lowly assassin, so...
Anyway, with everybody mounted up with horses that do not get tired, and since Alyssia knows the way, she will lead you towards the proper way. And it's not long before you, in just a couple of hours, you have already started to reach the clearing in front of the mansion. And you see the famous minefield that Alyssia thought, fuck it, let's just run through it.
So this is a minefield.
Also, Amanda, for your benefit, here is a picture of Lolly Hitler.
I know, I've seen some of that anime. Alicia, I know who you're talking
good
about.
Good shit.
Yeah. Alyssia looks at the minefield
hey,
and turns towards the party.
Hey, we're gonna attack you, okay? Blows
actually,
them up.
Experta.
Yes.
From what I can tell, has he like increased the minefield even more?
There's literally nowhere to walk. Everything's fucking mines.
Alyssia, it's like. Oh, I guess my entrance and my exit has caused him to redouble the minefield again.
Right, before we do...
He's basically quadrupled the mining field since the beginning.
Before we do anything, let's try getting his attention before we blow up his mines.
I'm gonna regret saying this, but I think Iris should approach first.
She nods. She hops down off her horse and basically goes to the edge kind of part of the minefield, more than a few feet like, away, just in case they explode.
Is even the main path to the house mine?
Everything is
and how
mine.
How the fuck did the horse get through?
The horses? You guys didn't enter the minefield yet.
No, the horse carrying the dude.
I remember in the beginning there weren't that many mines.
Hello.
He basically got lucky, got a little ways in, and then he hit the mine.
Yeah, it was like, hello!
As you raise your voice, suddenly there is a small pulse of blue light, and you see some kind of, almost like a firefly beginning to form up and hover around your area.
Hello?
As you do that, you see a few more are forming, and they're starting to gather around you guys.
Hey, by the way, I motion for the others to step back. It's like, we're here to talk.
At that point, as you continue making noise, the entire area around the spirit for the minefield lights up in more fireflies. This, you notice that this is some kind of search spell that Alyssia probably mentioned, and you can assess that your presence has been duly noted and you have been noticed. It's not long before, in the distance, you see that the door leading to the mansion, the front door, begins to open up. And somebody steps out in the doorway. You can probably imagine who. But let's go to him real quick, just a sec. We're moving.
I've never seen him before, so I have to imagine.
Go to him.
Oh, he's got white hair.
He totally looks like a battle butler.
He stands on the porch of the mansion and he snaps his fingers. You see that the fireflies are again starting to gather. Some are gathering around him, some are gathering around you guys, and soon you can hear his voice. And you notice that the fireflies are basically amplifying your voices so you can hear each other.
Oh, that's good. We're here to speak to you.
Speak or chug more arrows at me.
She looks down. I apologize for my scout's overzealousness. According to her, she thought you kidnapped someone.
I'm not a criminal.
I understand, and
if anything, the one that trespasses on this mansion is a criminal. Also an assailant.
She can't, like, defend against her. It's like, oh, he's white.
I heard that you had some trouble with your healing. I can temporarily help you with that.
You seem like a cleric. You're from the continent, yes?
Yes, that is correct.
You're telling me that a cleric from the Oven Empire wants to help a mage.
By the way, I speak up. To be fair, she left the order.
Yes, I'm trained as a cleric for the Oven Empire. I'm no longer with the church or the Ovean Empire at this moment, no.
At that moment, I hold up my amulet and go, we're with Noble Moon.
You see that he literally face palms and the tension drains from his face. He's not even mad, he's just dumbfounded. Honestly, how stupid do you take me for? He obviously doesn't believe you because you're a fucking Ovian, what the fuck?
If it will make you feel better, I will, and I'm really glad I have my pendant because this is a stupid fucking idea. I'll disarm and leave my shield and armor behind while I come to help you, if that makes you feel any better. I'll not have any weapons, I'll only be able to use magic, and from what I can tell, that would be extremely ineffective against you.
Oh? And why would it be extremely ineffective against me?
Because I cast energy and you could absorb that.
Huh. And how do you figure that? You see that suddenly he's very defensive. He realized that you know something that you probably shouldn't have.
I'm gonna take like a sudden wise action and go motion towards Alyssia. She described your little tussle. We're more or less guessing.
Try to bluff him because he's a mage and now he's super paranoid.
Look at him.
There's a long pause. He doesn't say anything for what feels like an eternity. You feel like things are probably gonna go bad, and you get, as the silence prolongs, you feel more and more tension. When suddenly he finally speaks up. So, you're telling me that you came to heal me as a way of apology for what happened to me earlier.
I will also not lie, but we wish to talk about something as well.
He thinks for a while. Then you see the communication break off. And he slowly goes back inside his mansion and the door closes behind him. The next moment, you see the entire minefield around the house lit up. You see all the armed mines.
I'm assuming
they all fade out and stop working.
he's disarmed the minefield. I'm pretty sure that's a go-ahead.
you can see him, like, breathe out. It's like, oh,
but does he want me to disarm?
He said nothing.
Didn't say so.
Yeah, right, well, guess enough. What? He's letting us all through, so... Hey, this house looks exactly like the other house. How amazing.
low budget. Deal with it.
Alicia's just like, that was a little bit too easy. Then again, perhaps he's trusting in the traps inside the house.
I'm sharply elbowing Horatius in the ribs. Stop trying to kill him! Everything's going okay! Just let me do the talking!
I think you'll find I haven't tried to kill him at all.
Stop preparing to try and kill him!
I give
one little
you a
piece
look
of advice. I would suggest none of you try to go off on your own.
Yeah, stick together.
Unless you fancy getting lost forever.
I'll take up the lead in case stuff goes bad. I have a tower shield.
Iris nods, so we are gonna resummon the horse into the thing and we're gonna walk across.
Now, I'm gonna meta this a little bit, but if Vendrick was somehow still in the party, he would have told you, yeah, we gotta leave, this guy's gonna kill us, because he's also a mage and knows how this shit works.
Oh no, if Vendrick was in the party, the difference would have been you wouldn't have been elbowing me as I prepared for when this shit eventually went wrong. You would have turned around, saw the puff of smoke, went, where the fuck did he go?
And then the guy's throat would be
inside
slit.
The banner.
Well, I guess we're walking across, and if he tries to kill us, well...
Also, Exposure,
guys...
I will give Lucy a look, but noticeably not put the arrows back into the quiver.
Wait. You have a bow and arrow?
I had a longbow, yes.
Oh. Wait, can a longbow actually hit him at that distance?
At 600, and with my ability, just about.
Yep, if he chooses to succeed, he can make it. Anyway, as you guys approach the mansion, as you can imagine, it's a pretty tense situation. Sure, the mines are off, but what if he randomly decides to put them on? Literally nowhere to step. Everything is a mine.
Tower shield
so,
surfing.
Pretty nerve-wracking.
Yep, tower shield surfing.
To your surprise, that actually doesn't happen. You managed to reach the front door of the mansion.
Well, yeah, he's going to wait for me to kill him.
Something that
Alicia
would have
before...
died trying to do last time.
Yeah. He's gonna wait for me to heal him before he kills us.
I mean, if it wasn't for the elemental, she would have succeeded.
Looks like Horatius is in full disbelief mode.
Yep.
There's no mage that can actually be okay in a decent human being. Lies. To be fair, he has had no other indication.
You guys. Enter the through the front door. The door creaks a little bit as you enter into the inner sanctum of this mysterious mage. As you look around, there's no sign of everybody. It's quiet. Where did he go? Why is it so quiet? As you're wandering there, standing, what happens next? Suddenly, you hear a pop. And then a... And you are surrounded by some kind of gas.
Great.
Can I pretend to be affected by it, by the way?
Pretend to be affected?
Yeah, me and her poisons? Are immune to poison.
It's not a poison, though, so whoops.
I imagine it's basically a smokescreen.
Everybody roll me a will save.
Any chance of a bonus because of my
yeah.
ardent disbelief in him?
Actually, yeah, like.
Wait,
Will
save.
Do you mean wisdom or charisma?
Wisdom.
Oh, by the way, everyone gets a +3 because they're standing near me.
So this is not a charm effect then?
No, it's not a charm effect.
Alright, so I rolled a 20.
Yeah, I rolled wrong first. So. What? No, that's...
How do we get... Why do we get a +3?
I have a +3.
Because I'm
no,
standing
No, we all
here.
Have +3.
Because I give you bonuses to all saves. Especially
oh,
any
so
chance
25.
Of,
Kick.
Any chance of advantage because of my ardent distrust from the very second we got here?
No, I'm sorry, Adam. You're gonna have
wow.
to just roll.
So
fuck
yeah, that's
you,
a
then.
10, 16. Which won't save me.
Yeah, 16 exposure.
So, Lucretia's the one that rolled the best, and that's a 20, right?
No, you rolled 25.
No, yeah.
She rolled a 9.
No, I rolled a 25. The other one was a mistake. That was not the right roll.
It's a wisdom save. What's wrong with it?
Because I rolled it on the thing. You can take it if you want. That's fine.
That's weird.
But yeah,
it seems
20.
To be the same roll. I don't get what's the difference.
He rolled it with auto advantage.
Mm-hmm.
Well, it's still a 9, so it's fine.
So I rolled a 20.
So the 20 is the highest. Sadly, yep. Lucretia, you fall one short.
Is what?
And
21?
Suddenly, as you are walking around, remember this guy has a demon inside him. So he kind of has some boosted stats. Meaning that as you guys walk around and enter the mansion, you feel your bodies act a little bit sluggish and different. Then there's a clank, a bang, as you all start inadvertently dropping your weapons. Before you manage to say anything, you all fall face first on the ground and hit your heads.
Hey, Amanda. It
hurts like a bitch.
Mm-hmm.
Heads or tails?
Heads.
It's a fucking dragon!
More like an ancient wyvern.